President Marcos orders structural changes in the office of the president. The palace issued Executive Order 11 Wednesday, which the president had signed on December 29th. The move classifies government agencies in the palace into 5 offices. One of these is the presidential management staff under the office of the executive secretary, Lucas Bersamin. The PMS, which oversees the president's undertaking, was previously a separate office from that of the executive secretary. Other offices include the chief presidential legal counsel, the communications office, the special assistant to the president, and the private office. Well, former government officials involved in last year's sugar importation mess cleared by the office of the president. Jervis Manaha now joins us with that story. Jervis.
Yes, Carmina. Officials of the Department of Agriculture and the Sugar Regulatory Administration involved in the sugar importation mess have all been absolved by the office of the president. In a document dated December 29, 2022, but only publicized today, the office of the president approved the recommendation of the Deputy Executive Secretary for Legal Affairs dismissing charges against 4 agriculture officials. This includes Agriculture Undersecretary Leocadio Sebastian, signed a sugar order on behalf of the president, and former SRA board officials Hermine Hilda Serafica, Aurelio Valderrama, and Roland Beltran. The decision stated that the investigation found officials who signed the order are in good faith and that no evidence points to misconduct. However, the officials were admonished to be more prudent and circumspect in their decisions. The decision was signed by Executive Secretary Lucas Bersamin with authority from the president. In a press statement, Sebastian said he is delighted. Yes. He also said this will enable them to move on from a traumatic and challenging experience. Beltran said this affirms that he did not betray public trust. Both officials supporters that stayed on their side during the ordeal. We are yet to hear from Serafica and Valderrama. Carmina.
All right. Thanks a lot, Jervis Manahan. Chinese President Xi Jinping commits to narrow the trade deficit gap between the Philippines and his country. According to Malacanang, Xi made the commitment during a bilateral meeting with President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. That's after the Philippine leader noted that while Beijing has become Manila's largest trading partner, there's an imbalance between exports and imports.
There has been created what we are now calling the Durian Protocol, because they are opening their trade to imports of durian and other agricultural products from the Philippines so that we can redress the imbalance in our imports and exports from China.
Marcos also told Xi the Philippines wants to resume negotiations on the joint oil and gas exploration project in the West Philippine Sea.
We said that we should come into partnership so that whatever experience we in the Philippines have, we can impart to them, the Chinese, and what China has experienced, they can also help us with the transfer of technology and the different strategies for the move to renewable energy.
During Marcos's state visit to China, Manila and Beijing inked 14 bilateral agreements on areas such as maritime security and infrastructure. Among the deals signed are on cooperation on the Belt and Road Initiative and on digital and information and communications technology. Marcos and Xi also discussed the plight of Filipino fishermen in the South China Sea. Marcos says Xi has vowed to find ways to improve the situation for Filipino fishermen. Ties between the two countries have been strained after a standoff between Chinese and Filipino vessels in the resource-rich Scarborough Shoal back in 2012.
And I was very clear in trying to talk about the plight of our fishermen. And the president promised that we would find a compromise and find a solution that will be beneficial so that our fishermen might be able to fish again in their natural fishing ground. We also discussed what we can do to move forward to avoid any possible mistakes, misunderstandings that could trigger a bigger problem than what we already have.
President Marcos is set to arrive home later this afternoon.